And today for your garden, let's get outside and get festive for fall. Take a look at these gorgeous ideas. What a beautiful way to combine the green of summer with the bright, vibrant colors of fall. Gardening guru Linda Vodder's here to show us how to make pumpkin topiaries for fall decorating. And you said this is really easy and even I can do it.
Oh my gosh, it is so easy. And the only thing that I think I love better than pumpkins are when you combine pumpkins with topiary, which is also
she
a passion
topiaries.
Of mine.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is so easy. So to do this project, what you want to assemble are first of all some topiary forms.
Okay.
And people always ask me, where can you get them? You can get them at garden centers, places like Hobby Lobby, Michaels, places like that.
Goodwill.
Which is okay,
place.
My secret. But you can also buy them online. These wire topiary standard forms, you can also buy them online.
Okay.
So if you're not seeing what you want, look online.
And yours are rusted, so they don't have to be new.
They're not, because I have had these for years and they just, there's a new iteration of them every season.
I love that. Yeah.
So,
perfect.
So to create this gorgeous centerpiece, which by the way would work outside or inside as, you know, the centerpiece to your dining room table, you want to get an 8-inch hanging basket that has long ivy tendrils.
Uh-huh.
And then you want to put it in an attractive terracotta pot or a concrete pot or something. And then basically all you're doing is taking the form, setting it on top of the pot, and then just weaving those long tendrils up and down the framework, so it doesn't even have to be really mature or have grown in place very long.
Okay.
You can do this almost instantly. When you're looking for your frame, just make sure that they've got big enough openings that you can literally stuff it with gourds and pumpkins.
And that's all you've done. It's not glued in or anything.
No. And because I know how finicky you are, this one is only in tones of white and cream and pale yellow. And then you can just kind of adorn it a little bit more with some Nandina berries, or someone was admiring this beautiful cluster of pecan holes that I have here.
Okay, now here's her secret for how she makes it look so great. Tell them.
Well, you know, and you said you did it to your pumpkins
yesterday.
Right? Yeah, yesterday. Yes. Okay, so you just get a clear enamel or a clear acrylic, or you used a polyurethane.
Yeah.
Basically anything that you can spray, and then you just give them a little kiss of glistening, you know, a little kiss of sunshine on the outside of the gourd itself. I typically don't do the whole thing because that makes it look a little bit fake, but I like to just capture the shoulders where the light will hit. Could be candlelight, could be sunlight. It makes the whole thing pop.
See, that's how we're different, because you can see a reflection in mine. I mean, maybe I hit it a little bit too much. How long can we expect these to stay?
Oh my gosh. Well, this one, I told you, it has been around the world several times.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had this one probably like this for 2 weeks. But the added component that I think gives it even more drama and makes it even more special is I took this terracotta pot.
Yeah.
And then I bought a $2 inexpensive
at the bottom.
pillar candle
uh-huh.
holder, and then I elevated the whole thing, because what makes it look really attractive to the eye is having things at different levels. So you can elevate some, keep some of them scattered about at the bottom, and voila.
And we love cheap, and she is the queen of cheap. And I gotta love that. I mean, that's a compliment. Now then, if you want more information about her website, if you haven't seen it, please go to it. It's lindavodder.com for your garden. It's fabulous. So take a look. I guarantee you're going to like it. Thank you, Linda Vodder.
Uh-huh.